The purpose of this video is to provide instructions for entering data into the Behavioral Health Detail, or BHD, section in MOTS. Entering client profile data is required before MOTS will accept behavioral health data. Instructions for entering data in the client profile section are in another video, which should be viewed before this one. Please review the MOTS reference manual for information about specific fields in the BHD section. This manual and other helpful tools can be found on the MOTS public website. This demonstration will take place in the MOTS training environment. For reference, here is the URL for the MOTS training environment and the email address for MOTS support. Remember, when using MOTS training, enter only false test data. Real clients should only be entered in the live production environment. After logging in, the MOTS homepage will display. From here, this demonstration will illustrate entering behavioral health detail data for the randomly generated test client who was entered in the client profile video. Click the Client Entry tab at the top of the screen. First, find the client. Always search for a client before entering a new record for him or her. This will help prevent the accidental creation of duplicate records for the same client. Confirm that the agency and facility fields contain the correct selections. Enter all or part of the client's last name, or enter all or part of the client's first name, or client ID, or Medicaid ID. In searching for a client, the less information entered or the broader the search criteria, the better. Simple differences in the spelling of a name may make existing clients difficult to find. Click the search button. The search results are displayed. When the correct client has been located, click any part of the line containing his or her name and other information. The client summary page will display. Under the Behavioral Health section is the assessment-only record that was previously submitted. This client is now entering treatment. Click the Add New TX Episode button. This will open the data entry forms to the Client Profile tab. All of the fields except Client Treatment Status are already completed. In the Client Treatment Status box, select Active. Before continuing, review all the other data fields and update any information that has changed since the client's last visit, such as employment. Some fields, such as date of birth and last name at birth, cannot be updated because they are considered key identifiers. If these need to be changed, contact MOTS support. When all the necessary updates have been entered, click the Behavioral Health Detail tab. Most of the fields on this page are required and must be completed before the record can be submitted. Rules behind this page prevent invalid data from being submitted. If MOTS detects invalid data, error messages will be displayed at the time of submission. Each field on this screen will be described in detail as example data is entered. Enter the date the client was admitted or otherwise engaged in services. Type the date or use the calendar icon to select a date. Enter the zip code of the client's current residence. Select the state in which the client currently resides. Typing an O in this field will auto-select Oregon. Note that Oregon is the first available selection in this field. If the client's residence is in another state, scroll through the list to find it, or type the first few letters to auto-select it. Enter the client's household monthly income. This refers to the household income, not the client's individual income. Enter 0 if the household has no income. Enter 1 if the client refuses to answer. Otherwise, enter the monthly household income amount. This client indicated that her household annual income is $24,000. $24,000 is not correct in this situation. The client provided her annual income amount. Divide it by 12 in order to submit the correct monthly amount. Select the option that best describes the principal source of the client's household income. This refers to the household income, not the client's individual income. Select the option or options that best identify the organization or individual paying for the client's services. Enter the total number of people, including the client, who are dependent on the income indicated in the estimated gross monthly household income field. The entry in this field cannot be 0. Enter the total number of individuals aged 17 years old or younger who are dependent on the income indicated in the estimated gross monthly household income field. If the client is 17 or younger and has no dependents, enter 1. Select the option that best describes the client's health insurance. Select the option or options that best describe the individuals and/or organizations referring the client for services. Select the option or options that best describe the individuals and/or organizations to whom the client will be or has been referred at the conclusion of treatment. For new clients, none may be the most appropriate selection. Select the option or options that best describe the client's tribal affiliation. Indicate the type of interpreter needed, if any, for communicating with the client. For MOTS reporting purposes, interpreter is defined as an individual hired to provide professional interpretation for this client. For new submissions, indicate whether the client is pregnant when entering treatment. For update submissions, indicate whether the client is pregnant during treatment. Remember to update this field if the client's pregnancy status changes during treatment. Otherwise, state records may show a client is pregnant for more than 9 months. For male clients, select NA. Enter the number that best represents the highest school grade the client has completed. This could be higher than 12 if the client has completed any years of college, such as 14 for an associate's degree or 16 for a bachelor's degree. Indicate whether the client currently uses tobacco products, including e-cigarettes. Indicate whether the client has used any non-prescribed drugs or alcohol in the last 90 days. Select the option or options necessary to identify the client as in a DUII program, on probation, on parole, etc. Please note that a 90-day civil commitment is not the same as a court-mandated 90-day DUII diversion program. These four fields are required for addiction clients, but can be left blank for mental health clients. Enter the number of times the client has been arrested in the past month and overall for DUII charges and in general. Please keep these entries consistent with the legal status field if possible. A client cannot logically be incarcerated or on parole if he or she has never been arrested. At least one DUII lifetime arrest is required for clients with a DUII convicted or DUII diversion legal status. Enter the client's driver's license or Oregon identification number, if known, as issued by Oregon DMV. It should be 7 characters long, including leading zeros if applicable, and begin with a number or the letter A. Do not enter license or identification numbers issued by other states or countries. If the client has a state identification number, which is assigned to individuals in the criminal justice system, and if it is known, enter it in this field. SID numbers are 6 or 8 digits long. In each of these 3 fields, select the option that best describes the client's school engagement if he or she is 25 years old or younger and in school. Otherwise, select NA. Because the list of ICD-10 diagnosis codes is very large, the search criteria in MOTS was separated into 3 categories. The in-use selection shows any diagnosis codes that were selected in previous episodes recorded for this client. The behavioral selection searches codes specific to behavioral health issues. The all selection searches the entire list of codes. Select one of the 3 filters. Begin typing the description or code for the applicable diagnosis. If searching by ICD-10 code, do not enter the decimal point. Multiple diagnoses can be selected. To remove a diagnosis, click the Delete command. MOTS will ask for confirmation. Global Assessment of Functioning, or GAF score data, no longer needs to be submitted to MOTS. This field will be removed as part of a future system update. Select the option that best describes whether peer-delivered services were or will be offered to the client as part of his or her treatment. Select the option that best describes the general outcome of any infectious disease risk assessment that was conducted. This field identifies key performance indicators that are significant to the client's treatment plan and goals for recovery. select one or more of the available options. These two fields are only completed for adult mental health clients in residential services. If this test client was in that situation, a level of care would be selected, and a score between 0 and 100 would be entered. The Behavioral Health Detail section is now complete. If the client is or will be enrolled to receive addiction services, the Addiction Detail tab would be completed as well. For this demonstration, the client is only enrolled for mental health services. Click the Submit button and watch for any error messages. An error has been found on the client profile screen. Because Medicaid OHP was selected as the primary source of payment, MOTS now requires the client's Medicaid ID. Fix the error by entering a valid Medicaid ID. A placeholder will be entered for this test client, but only valid Medicaid IDs can be entered for real clients in the live production environment of MOTS. Upon clicking or tabbing out of the field, the error message should disappear if the data discrepancy has been resolved. The tab at the top of the screen will remain red until the record is successfully submitted. Attempt to submit again. If MOTS does not discover any more errors, it will return to the client summary page, indicating that new information has now been submitted. An active behavioral health episode of care has now been recorded for this client. During treatment, submit updates to show changes in the client's situation. This is done by reviewing the existing behavioral health record. For example, the client's employment status and living arrangement may change. Status updates like these are required every 90 days or more frequently, but submitting updates more often, such as every 30 days or as changes occur, ensures more accurate data. Update the behavioral health screen as well. For example, the client's source of income, monthly household income, and substance use in the last 90 days may change. When all updates have been entered, return to the Client Profile tab. When treatment has concluded, update the Client Treatment Status field by selecting the option that best describes the reason for ending this episode of care, then click the Submit button. MOTS will produce a warning message. When the client treatment status is changed from active to any other status, the episode of care will be closed. After this point, it cannot be reopened and updates cannot be submitted. Always update the client profile and behavioral health screens before changing the client treatment status to ensure that the client's current situation is reported. Updating the client treatment status first may result in records that show zero change or improvement from the beginning of the episode to the end. To confirm, click Yes. The episode of care is now closed. This concludes the demonstration of the behavioral health section. To continue learning about entering data into MOTS client entry, please review the next video on the addiction detail section.